Mom, is this your first time at Symbols?
Yeah, it is my first time here at Symbols.
Did you enjoy it?
I thoroughly enjoyed it. I mean, it was so much fun. Everybody here, the hospitality is great, honestly. I wanted to specially mention it because everybody took care of all my needs and everything. And the talent here was amazing. So overall, it was a lot of fun.
Thank you, Mom. So, Mom, do you plan, like, you mentioned that you worked on Khairiyat, right?
Yeah.
What exactly were you doing?
So, as I told you, I've assisted Pritam sir. Like, I'm assisting Pritam sir on his project. So, that was his song. So, we worked on the song as a team. Like, I assist him. So, as a sound engineer, sometimes I sing for him also. And, like, it's like a part of the process of a song, when, like, how the song is made, that in that process I'm also involved. So all the projects that Pritam sir is doing, I'm also like a part of them.
So you judge the thing, right? The Hindi singing competition.
Yeah.
Do you enjoy judging?
Yes, I actually had a lot of fun because I know how it feels to be a contestant. Yeah. I've been there a lot of times. I mean, I've participated in college fests and a lot of competitions. I've given so many auditions. Before cracking Saregamapa, I had given quite a lot of auditions and I'd failed a lot of times. So I know exactly how it feels, and it honestly for me it feels great that now at least I'm able to, you know, help other people who want to grow and who want to do good in music.
Compared to the last decade, the interest towards music has increased. Hmm. So there's a lot of competition out there.
Yeah.
So if you were to give an advice to all the budding singers out there, what would it be?
Honestly, just one thing I also noticed here, I told one of the contestants also ki you shouldn't try singing like the original singer. Any song you're trying, make it your song. It has to sound ki agar main gaane ga to lagna chahiye ki Harjot ki voice hai. Kisi ko ye nahi lagna chahiye ki yaar Ishar uski bhi lag rahi hai voice, ya uski bhi ho sakti hai kisi aur singer ki lag rahi hai. I have to make it my own. So all I want to say is own the song. It is your song. At that very moment when you're singing, it's your song. It's nobody else's. And when you're singing on the stage, just try to remember one thing. Because there were a lot of people who were nervous today. Just ki wajah se their performance got hampered. They could have done really well. Unme potential dikh raha tha, but because of the nervousness, wo apna 100% nahi de paaye. It has happened with me also a lot of times. So, but you need somebody to tell you ki nahi, it's fine. Zyada se zyada kuch nahi hoga, tum competition se nikal jaoge, maximum hai wo. It's not that bad. So you just have to, at that time you have to think ki audience mein sab log bevkoof hai, unko kuch nahi pata hai. Only you know ki gaana kya hota hai. And sing like it, that's it. Enjoy each and every moment, because singing on the stage is another rush, another feeling, crazy good feeling that you have. वो बहुत कम लोगों को opportunity मिलती है वो. So just enjoy that time.
Thank you, ma'am. We are glad to have you on Symbols. I hope you have a great time.
Yes, I did. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ma'am. First of all, we're really happy to have you here. How was your journey from Pune to here? Was it comfortable? All good?
Yeah, you guys made sure that it is comfortable, so thank you, and thank you for having me here.
Yes.
The journey obviously was really, I was actually looking forward to this fest because I have heard from a lot of people that your fest is one of the best. Like, honestly, not just because I'm here today, but I have heard this from a lot of people. So I was any which way looking forward to be here, and now that I have experienced one of your events, so I can say that it was, yes, you guys did justice to what I heard.
Yes,
so
this is your first time in Symbols.
Yes, first time.
Welcome.
Thank you.
So we would start with talking about you.
Mm-hmm.
So you are one of the most popular Indian YouTube channels for dance and choreography presently. What do you feel about it, and how was dance an inspiration?
Obviously, it's a great feeling because you know what the work, what you create in between four walls, and when you put it out and people support by loving, liking, sharing it all over, and people talk about it. So definitely it's a great feeling. But at the same time, when you get so much support and love from people, it also motivates you to put out more things. So yes, it's a great feeling.
So how was your experience here? How did you like all the performances?
It was really good. It was amazing because everyone who performed on stage today, they were damn enthused. They had good energy. Also, people like audience, they were throwing good energy to your performance. Mm-hmm. So you don't get to see that on daily basis. Like you would only see people who would cheer for the ones who are really good. Mm-hmm. But they were so good to everyone. So that is one plus point that I loved. You know, it creates automatically a positive energy even for the performers. And of course, I think there were eight crews.
Eight, yeah. Yes.
I think all of them were really great. So I really don't like the system of like selecting, but I think each one of them really performed well. Like there was this one crew, and I actually announced on stage that I want to do a video with them because they were so good, because I love their style. So yeah.
Well, we're so glad you enjoyed all of this, and just we hope you have a good time here again. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So good afternoon, ma'am. We're really glad to have you here, and welcome back to Symbiosis. So you just gave us a really interesting session out there.
Thank you.
And so talking about it, you mentioned that you were the youngest Indian female to scale Mount Everest.
I was the youngest Indian to have climbed Everest. There was no female or male at that point because there was no male that had climbed Everest that young. So I was the youngest Indian to have climbed
Everest. That's commendable.
Yes.
So, just summing up the session, what got you into mountaineering in the first place?
Well, I would say that as a child, I had been going into the mountains for almost every summer of my life, and so I trekked a lot. I grew up in Pune, so I went for a lot of climbing camps around Pune. Pune has quite a culture for climbing and rock climbing and trekking. And I think that I was involved in that since a very young age. I was always the youngest person in my batch. And so I think, as actually a family, me and mom still talk about it sometimes, that we never thought that mountaineering was a career. Yes, we knew Bachendri Pal had climbed Mount Everest, but we did not have the working knowledge of knowing that mountaineering A is a sport, or that you could actually live your life having become a mountaineer. That was not something that was normal. So it was never a dream to become a mountaineer or to even climb Everest. The dream was to always climb, and because of that dream to climb, Everest happened, and you know, the rest of the things happened. It wasn't the other way around. It wasn't that for Everest I learned how to climb. I already knew how to climb, and then Everest.
That's great. Yeah, so being able to talk to yourself is a big thing, and you've done that well. So do you think that has helped you in a lot of your motivational speaking that you've done? Yeah, I have seen that you have a lot of TED Talks under your experience. So what do you think is the main part of you being able to engage an audience? Like, what do you think is the most important thing here?
So, if you pick up any of my talks again, you'll never see any of them. They can be close to each other, but they're never exactly the same. Again, I think public speaking is something that was introduced in school to us, and whether you were good at it or not, you were pushed into doing these things. And again, I think Symbiosis is something that made that happen. And always been grateful for that. So I think even public speaking or speaking to an audience is something that, you know, A, you should have something to say that you want to leave the public with, that you want to leave the audience with, that could be in their genre or their thought process or what they're thinking right now. It's great to be in this position to know where you all are right now, or to at least not exactly know where you all are, but roughly know where you all are and what you're thinking, because, you know, we were there at that point. And of course, things were extremely different from what they were when we were young. But I think that want to be able to tell your next generation something that they can build up to, I think, is the good thing about motivational speaking. And it's great to do it with kids and in schools and colleges. Of course, when you're speaking to bigger people that have already achieved a lot and are probably your colleagues, and when you're speaking to them, it's a completely different thing. But I think, I think you always need to have something that you want to leave the audience with. And as long as that is happening, that flow of energy is happening, you can get them on board. You can get them to understand what you're saying.
So just, how was your experience here?
It was excellent. I mean, I literally was, pulled out of Netflix and chill, and I ran. But it was symbiosis, and we came, and I was like, oh my god, I need like half an hour of shut eye before I go on stage, because I think I was literally awake the whole night, and I think we figured everything out by 2:30, and the cab was coming by 5. So but it was fun. And I mean, my mother, in the morning when I spoke to her at 9, because till then she didn't even know that I had left.
Yeah.
And I tried waking her up before I left, and she didn't wake up. She was like, what? They called you at 1? And I was, and she was like, you said yes? I was like, mama, if I didn't say yes, who will say yes?
Yeah.
Like, so I think it's a great story to tell.
Yes.
And I'm glad that I got to be a part of it.
Thank you so much for putting in these efforts. It was a pleasure having you.
Same.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
हमारे साथ आज एमजी बेला सर हैं, ये एमटीवी हसल के विनर रह चुके हैं।
सर काफी हार्ड परफॉर्मेंस, काफी हार्ड परफॉर्मेंस था।
स्टूडियो में कैसा किया? मैं भी नॉट बीन टू अ बार बार भाई, देखते हो टीवी पे करते हो कॉल, इससे पहले कभी कुछ मेरा हाल चाल।
आपका नाम से एमसी बेला काफी हटके नाम है, लाइक अपन नाम ऐसे दीपक सिंह है, बट लाइक योर रैपर नेम एमसी बेला काफी हटके, तो क्या इंस्पिरेशन क्या है इस नाम के पीछे?
इंस्पिरेशन इज लाइक के कुछ बड़ा मोटिव नहीं है मेरे को, हमेशा से जब से रैप करना मैंने शुरू किया ना, एक ही चीज़ था कि बदलाव लाने का, एक सब एक ही चीज़ कर रहे हैं, मेरे को थोड़ा हटके करना है कि लाइक अंडरग्राउंड को ऊपर उठाना, तो एक बदलाव जो था वो दिमाग में छप गया था कि बदलाव रखना है मेरे को, बट बदलाव नाम पे सूट नहीं करता। सो आई वाज वन डे आई वाज वॉचिंग जी टीवी, सो लाइक के एम, ओके मैं जी, मैंने कहीं सुना था मैंने कहीं पे कि जी इज द लास्ट अल्फाबेट, मैंने कहा ठीक है अगर बनना है तो आखिरी बनेंगे, शुरुआत तो सब करते हैं, आखिरी खत्म करेंगे हम, ठीक है एम जी बेला, बेला का जब मैंने बेला नाम रखा था ना, सो मेरे को ऐसा हुआ कि मेरी लाइफ में बहुत सारी चेंजेस आ गए, बहुत अच्छी हो गई थी लाइफ, मेरे को लिखने में मज़ा आने लगा था, लेकिन एक पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड जिसे कहते हैं वो आ गया था, सो मैंने इनको जोड़ दिया और बेला का मतलब मैंने लग गया बदलाव, सो अगर आप जोड़ो तो बनता है मैं आखिरी बनता हूँ, दैट्स द मीनिंग ऑफ।
आपने शुरुआत गाने से की थी, फिर आप रैपिंग में आ गए, क्या बदला?
गाने तो इसलिए क्योंकि सब गाने कर रहे थे, मैंने कहा हम भी कर लेंगे, बट इसलिए नहीं कि सब रैप कर रहे तो हमें भी रैप करना है, नहीं रैप मुझे इसलिए करना था क्योंकि माय मॉम शी इज अ पोएट, वो कवि है, सो उनको अपने सपने पूरे करने का मौका नहीं मिला क्योंकि फैमिली बैकग्राउंड बहुत इतना सही नहीं था, सो मैंने कहा अब करना है तो फिर इस हिसाब से करते हैं कि उनका भी नाम ऊपर है, तो इसलिए मैं रैपर हूँ, इसलिए मैंने गाने वाने छोड़ दिए, गाने में अब भी गाता हूँ, ऐसा कोई सीन नहीं, गानों से कोई दुश्मनी नहीं है, बट स्टिल रैप इज ऑन नंबर वन।
सर आपकी यूट्यूब वीडियोस पे 1 मिलियन से भी ज्यादा व्यूज हैं, आप काफी पॉपुलर हो, लाइक आपको लाइक एमटीवी हसल किस हद तक आपको लग रहा है आपको वहां तक पहुंचाने में ये था?
एमटीवी हसल से पहले लाइक गानों पे ठीक थे व्यूज, लाइक 10,000-20,000 इतने तो आ ही रहे थे, तो मेरे को लगता है कि पहले एम टी वी हसल से पहले मैंने 8 साल बहुत हसल किया, लाइक कभी जयपुर कभी दिल्ली कभी कहाँ कहाँ, सो उसकी वजह से आई थिंक कि उसका ही फल मिला एक हसल के रूप में, हमको बहुत ज़रूरत थी रैपर्स को, क्योंकि रैपर्स को मौके नहीं मिलते, सिंगिंग शोज बहुत आते हैं, रैपिंग शो पहला था, सो उस वजह से हमको बहुत सपोर्ट मिला, और जो गाने 10,000 जा रहे थे आज वो 1-1 मिलियन जा रहे, तो मेरे को अब यही लगता है कि शायद मेरे गानों में कमी नहीं थी, मेरे पास जनता नहीं थी, काम मैं वही कर रहा था, मेरे पास जनता नहीं थी, तो जिन लोगों को ऐसा लगता है कि हमारा शायद काम अच्छा नहीं इसलिए हमारे व्यूज नहीं आ रहे, नहीं तुम्हारे पास जनता नहीं, काम सबका अच्छा, इट्स लाइक मेरा तो यही सोच है। सर
आपके करंट एस्पिरेशंस क्या है, व्हाट इज वन थिंग यू आर लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू?
कि मेरे को पिक्चर बनना है सीधा वही सोच रहा हूँ मैं तो काम ही ऐसे करो पिक्चर ही बन जाए। रैप करना शुरू किया ना तभी मैंने सोच लिया था, तब मैं 12th, मतलब कि नहीं जब मैंने रैप करना शुरू किया तब मैं 8th में था, ट्वेल्थ तक आते आते मैं समझ गया कॉलेज नहीं जाना है, कॉलेज में जाना तो शोज के लिए जाना वरना नहीं जाना, तो कॉलेज करना ही नहीं है, तो वही चक्कर में मैं ट्वेल्थ फेल हो गया। सो मैं तो ट्वेल्थ पास भी नहीं, इट्स लाइक के एक होता है कि आपकी जर्नी कुछ और होती है, ठीक है। मेरे को जितना स्कूल से समझ में आया, मैं ये नहीं कहता कि मत पढ़ो, पढ़ना बहुत ज़रूरी है, कि बिना पढ़े आप कुछ नहीं कर सकते इस दुनिया में। मेरे को जितना पढ़ना था मैंने उतना पढ़ा, मुझे समझ में आ गया कि अब मैं नहीं पढ़ना चाहता, मुझे यही करना है, तो मैंने रहा, इसलिए कॉलेज तो कभी गए नहीं, तो वो तो सवाल ही नहीं आता। मेरे को तो पता ही नहीं कॉलेज लाइफ होती है ऐसी है, इतना पता है शोज में जाते तो बाउंसर होते हैं। That's all I know.
Sir, आपका first अपने rap song मतलब कैसे और कब लिखा और कैसे आपको inspiration है?
First rap मतलब अब इंडियन अगर आप किसी भी rapper को पूछोगे ज़्यादातर यही बोलेंगे लोग, मैं बुद्धिमिया पाजी को सुन के आगे बढ़ा। So मेरे लिए भी वही था कि बैठा था एक दिन, किसी ने मेरे को ऐसे ही बोला कि रैप भी नाम की कोई चीज़ होती है, तो सिर्फ मैं तो शायरियाँ लिखता था क्योंकि मॉम से इंस्पायर था मैं तो अपनी, मैं आज भी अपनी मॉम से इंस्पायर्ड हूँ, मैं किसी आर्टिस्ट से इंस्पायर्ड नहीं हूँ, मैं सिर्फ अपनी मॉम की तरह बनना चाहता हूँ। द पॉइंट इज दिस, क्योंकि वो बहुत अच्छा लिखती हैं, तो मैंने सोचा यही लिखता हूँ, लिखते लिखते मैंने एक दिन रोहिने बाजी को सुन लिया, मैंने कहा अच्छा ये भी हो सकता है, तो मैंने रैप करना शुरू कर दिया।
सर आपकी मॉम का वर्क इंटरनेट पे मिलेगा क्या?
नहीं, क्योंकि उन्होंने मतलब शादी के बाद सब छोड़ दिया।
अच्छा,
ओके, तो उनसे आगे मैं अपनी एल्बम में उस पर काम करने की सोच रहा हूँ, लाइक एक होता है कि गाने से पहले कुछ उनके बोल करके, तो मैं अपनी एल्बम में सोच रहा हूँ, बट अभी कुछ रिवील नहीं करना चाहता मैं उस बारे में।
थैंक यू सो मच,
थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग।